Hello everyone. This video is part one in a series on the basics of searching for biomedical or pharmaceutical information on Dialog. Biomedical and pharma research, along with searches for pharmacovigilance purposes, are among the strongest use cases for Dialog. Later we'll talk about some of the special tools and steps that you can use in Dialog for best results. And here in part one, we'll start with the content offered by Dialog for this kind of search. These are STEM databases, that is, science, technology, engineering, and medicine databases, and most of them are abstracting and indexing databases rather than containing the full text. They're designed to help you find relevant articles easily using term searches and several kinds of special indexing added to the Dialog records to enhance your retrievals. Searchers often find that for these purposes, the abstracts combined with indexing are actually more effective than trying to search through the full text of an article. But many of these records contain a link called a DOI, or Digital Object Identifier, that can take you to sites outside of Dialog where you could get the full text if the full text is not present in Dialog. And many of our customers subscribe to services that can provide the full texts once you've identified the best results using Dialog. If your company does use a full-text provider like that, Dialog is designed to integrate the links to those full-text resources so that you can go to those full-texts directly from a record or a results list in Dialog very smoothly. That's something we can help you with, and you may want to discuss that with your Dialog representative. So what are the databases in Dialog for biomed and pharma searching? Dialog has many of them, but to get started, the three databases most commonly used for this kind of research are Medline, Embase, and Biosys Previews. Medline is Dialog's implementation of the information from PubMed, which you may be familiar with. This is a deep archive going back to the 1940s. It's very medically oriented, and it covers the broad field of biomedicine, including, for example, dentistry, nursing, veterinary medicine, and psychology. It updates daily, so the information's very timely. Medline, as we'll see, features an indexing system called the MeSH subject headings with an interactive thesaurus to help you target your searches very easily. Medline also includes what are called publisher records, which are early release electronic versions of articles posted before the full bibliographic information is known. Embase is an excellent database with indexing focused on human medicine and on pharmaceuticals and medical devices. You'll especially want to use Embase if you're doing any kind of pharmaceutical research. Embase also has a thesaurus, which we'll talk about in later videos, so it's easily searchable for finding targeted information, and it also is updated daily. Biosys Previews is somewhat broader in scope, covering the biological or life sciences as well as the biomedical sciences, so that in addition to the full range of medical topics, Biosys covers such areas as microbiology, biophysics, botany, and public health. Biosys updates on a weekly basis. An important feature of many biomed databases on Dialog is that they cover conference proceedings. So if you're interested in breaking or interim research that's not yet published in the literature, you may want to take advantage of the conference papers available on Dialog. Conference papers are not available in Medline or in PubMed, but they are in both Embase and Biosys. And in the conference papers, you'll find unique and cutting-edge information not yet available elsewhere to get a more comprehensive view of the literature using Dialog. Many searchers find that Medline, Embase, and Biosys together are an ideal combination for setting up alerts to automatically search for new information about adverse effects of drugs, the kind of current awareness search also known as pharmacovigilance. Each of these databases brings unique value to your results, and if any of the same articles are retrieved in multiple databases, Dialog will automatically remove any duplicates by default. Another great source for conference information is Northern Light Life Sciences Conference Abstracts. This database is a relatively recent addition to Dialog. It covers information from conferences worldwide in the life sciences, biomedicine, and pharmacology, which is provided by conference sponsors, though it may be months or years before publication in journals. Northern Light also provides unique access to so-called gray literature that is reported at conferences but may never be fully published, which can be of critical importance to research and development professionals and others interested in the newest information. In addition, there are several other databases I'd like to highlight for you. Derwent Drug File contains abstracts written by experts at Derwent in a way that captures the cogent information from the full text of articles and makes it more accessible by simple searching. PsycInfo covers the international psychological literature. This is a very deep archive, and if you're researching a topic that has to do with human behavior, in this database you'll find there's a great deal of overlap between these topics and the hard science aspects of biomedicine. And there are many other databases in Dialogue that may be important to you in any or all of your research projects. I won't read all of this out loud to you, but I will show you in just a couple of minutes how to easily get more information about any of the databases. You'll see that some of these are very much about drugs, or about food science or other specific topics. You might want to include databases that cover the business developments in the health and pharmaceutical fields. Gale Group databases can help with that. And a couple of databases you might not immediately think of as biomedical databases would include ProQuest Newsstand Professional, which is a comprehensive archive of newspaper articles from around the United States and the world. Newspapers can be a great resource for health and drug information, both recent and historical. And again, it's a very deep archive. From about 1983 forward, these articles are available in full text. ProQuest Dissertations and Theses has the largest collection of graduate and doctoral dissertations that you'll find anywhere. And if you want to do a deep dive into a particular topic, whether it's biomedical or anything else, you may want to consider this database. This database generally provides full text as well, assuming the author gave permission, so this can be another great resource in appropriate cases. So that is an overview of what the biomed databases are. As to how you'd go about selecting your databases in Dialogue in order to start your search, we have a separate video on that, and I'll put a link to it in the description below. But here are just a few points about going into the biomed databases. First, if you use the method of clicking on the icons to go into a pre-selected group of databases, notice that there are three that relate to biomed and pharma. One is called Diagnostics and Medical Devices, another is called Healthcare, and there's one called Pharmaceutical and Biomedical. You'll find the same set of icons in the Advanced Search screen, and if you click on any one of these, you'll be placed automatically into a content collection of databases for that subject. Second, if you click up here to see the full list of databases so you can select them manually with check marks, you may notice that some of the database names have a plus sign next to them, including, for example, ProQuest Biological and Healthcare Professional. And if you click on the plus sign, that will expand the list of all the databases that are nested within that one title. So really, Dialogue has far more databases than you might think, and these can be selected or deselected individually if you like. And third, if you want to create some custom database shortcuts to get into any combination of databases that you'd like to use, which I recommend, you might consider creating one like I have here that I named Biomed 3 Databases. And this will take me directly into the three databases I spoke of earlier as basic to your biomed searching, Medline, Embase, and Biosys. And finally, note that after you've selected your databases and gone into them, if you go back to the basic search screen, you'll find a very good set of thumbnail descriptions of these databases. This is very helpful information, especially when you're first getting to know all the databases available, and it's easy to get to. Then, if you want to know more about any of the databases, you can go up here to ProSheets to get to the ProSheet for any database. So if I want to know everything about Medline and how to search in that database, I just click to get to the Pro Sheet. So that's it for the summary of the databases available for biomedical, pharmaceutical, or pharmacovigilance searching on Dialog. If you'd like more information, here are some links to additional resources, and if you have a question or you'd like some help, feel free to call the help desk at these numbers or email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.